University. He has completed his PhD from the same department, Madurai Kamarajar University, in the year 1994. He had cleared UGC NET in the year 1986 and awarded Robert Coheran Overseas Travel Fellowship from Royal Society of Tropical Medicine and Hygiene, London, UK, for training in microsatellite mapping in leprosy families at Wellcome Trust Centre for Human Genetics, Oxford University. His research specialization is HLA immunogenetics and working on immunogenetic polymorphism and their susceptibility or protective association in a number of diseases. Presently, he is the Vice President of Indian Immunology Society, New Delhi. He has published 50 research papers in reputed international journals, including Nephrology, Nature Genetics, PNAS, and Journal of Infectious Diseases, to name a few. He has completed a number of government-funded research projects to the fund of rupees 2. He has completed a number of government-funded research projects to the fund of rupees 2 crores and has organized several workshops and conferences. He is offering HLA tissue typing and donor matching services to a number of hospitals through industrial consultancy cell, EMKU. Now, I hand over the session to Dr. K. Balakrishnan. Balakrishnan, sir. Sir, Balakrishnan, sir, am I audible? Sir, unmute your microphone and continue the session, sir. Balakrishnan, sir, please unmute your microphone.
Yes, madam. Yeah. Good morning to everyone.
Good morning.
Yeah.
Sir, just a second, sir. I request all the participants. This is Dr. Syed Zamir. I request all the participants to kindly mute your microphones so that the speaker couldn't have any disturbances, because some of them are leaving and rejoining again. During that time, it is unable to mute all. So I request all the participants to mute yourself so that.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Request you all. This is a humble request. Thank you.
Okay.
Sir, you can carry over, sir.
Good morning, everyone. Outset, I really submit my heartfelt thanks to the management of KSR institutions, who is very nicely organizing this highly beneficial session for the benefit of faculty members, researchers, students, and general public at large. Also, I thank at the outset the principal of the college and the Nature Science Foundation group, particularly Dr. Rajalakshmi and Maithili, who consistently contacted me over a phone a couple of days and meticulously took all steps to make this event possible with great success. Good morning to everyone. I hope this session will be interesting for you. I feel this is the first session for all the participants. My topic of presentation is what is research. It's really a very basic and fundamental concept. Being a biologist and immunologist, I really focus many of the points that I want to discuss related to biology, to some extent biochemistry, chemistry, and environmental sciences. But of course, the initial slides, 10, 15 slides, 20 slides or so, will give the audience the broad idea about what is research, what are all the approaches, different ways and means to do research. A very nice picture, the apple tree and apples. The great science came from this apple tree. Under this apple tree, Newton identified the gravitational force. Very simple principle, right? But the point at which he identified this principle and the way in which he demonstrated really matters, enlightened the world like anything. So science resides everywhere, in small objects, small things, which is little things, which is very much around us. So one can select the topics from close environment, where they are living or where they are moving around. Coming to the topic, what is research? Research conducted by the purpose of contributing towards science by the systematic collection, interpretation, evaluation of data, and that too in a planned manner is scientific research. Of course, the scientific definition for anybody to easily understand. Further, the research is a logical and systematic research, search for new and useful information on a particular topic. So it must be a focused one. That is why it is a particular topic, be it biology, be it physical sciences, be it history, be it commerce or management. You have to choose a topic which is really very much specific or very, very specific or particular to a particular topic, both in scientific and non-scientific fields. There's so many people gave different definitions, but of course the core of the definition of what is research is same almost. Research is a careful and systematic patient study and investigation in some fields of knowledge and taken to establish facts or principles as demonstrated as presented by the Grinnell. And Intel Corporation also gave a beautiful definition for what is research. Research is a process by which people discover or create new knowledge about the world in which they live. Of course, we want to do research which is relevant to our life, which is relevant to our lives, or which is relevant to our environment. That's more important. Of course, all the technological research also revolves around this concept. According to Redman and Mori, very ancient definition, 1923 itself, he defined research as a systematized effort to gain new knowledge. So the scientific inquest must gain new knowledge. One should not do what other people did. One should not move around or dig around the junk already deposited. So you have to select a topic which will contribute much for the new knowledge. What is existing, over and above, we need to contribute a new knowledge. Coming to the meaning of research, research means a search for knowledge. It aims at finding out truth, scientific truth, art of scientific investigation, the methodologies, approaches, so scientific investigation, and way of thinking. Yeah, not only doing some practical work and finding some results. The research will give the way of thinking, different ways, different people think differently. So critically examining aspects of daily life, fact-finding process, a movement from the known to unknown. Beautiful definition, actually. Research is an organized and systematic way of finding the answers to the questions. So approach, many people define approach in a different way. So research approach, broadly divided into quantitative approach and qualitative approach. Am I audible?
You're audible only, sir. Please
proceed. Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, sir. You are audible.
Yeah, great. So basically, the research approach divided broadly into quantitative and qualitative. Further, you can one can make a lot of differences, a lot of branches, further bifurcations. Inferential approach, experimental approach, and simulation approach. Of course, there are a couple of other methodologies and approaches that also is there. Let us keep discuss about various approaches, various ways of doing research, or various ways of approaching research. So once again, the objective of the research is to gain familiarity with the phenomena or to achieve new insights into the exploratory or formulative research studies. Yeah, one can do both formulative research studies or exploratory research. Also descriptive research studies, diagnostic research, hypothesis, testing research studies. So it depends. Research is a vast area and research selection is a vast and highly dynamic area, ever-changing. What the research they did 18th century is not applicable to the present century, right? Of course, what they did 20 years ago is not applicable to today's context. So research is highly dynamic, ever-changing, because human lives are changing, environment is changing, technology is changing. So research is also constantly changing and constantly evolving phenomena. So area of conducting research are also highly diverse, need not necessarily restricted to science, need not necessarily restricted to management, need not necessarily restricted to commerce. Anybody can do any research, depends on their specialization and their interest. If you see 16th, 17th and 18th century scientists, those who studied philosophy contributed much for biology. Those who studied biology contributed much for philosophy and religion. If you take example, Hugo de Vries, the geneticist, then the evolutionary biologist Darwin, Gregor Mendel, they are all from different walks of life. They contributed much for the specific subjects. Likewise, there are great scientists who contributed much for physics, chemistry, and other subjects. Likewise, for political science, philosophy, sociology, also scientists contributed across disciplines. So the area of conducting research is highly diverse. So characteristics of research, again, it is highly diverse. A systematic approach must be followed for accurate data. Rules and procedures are an integral part of the process that set to the objective. Research is based on logical reasoning. So it's not just like that one can select the topic and do some research. It will become a junk. You have to, selecting a topic and doing a research is based on some logical reasoning. Then only it is much useful to the society. Involves both inductive and deductive methods. The data or knowledge that is derived is in real time from actual observations in natural settings. Research creates path for generating new questions. Yeah, this is very important. The research must create a path for generating new questions. You must ask new questions and try to answer that question. Need not necessarily you have to answer the question, right? You can contribute something, even 20%, 50%, sufficient. Leave it for the next generation to complete it. So the concept is you must generate new questions. Your focus topic must be in such a way to generate new questions. That is more important. Accuracy is one of the most important aspects of the research. That is really needed, very much needed. Without accuracy, if you publish anything or if you brought out anything, that won't help the future researchers, that won't help the humanity, that won't help the society. So in the information that is obtained should be accurate and true to its nature. This is the central core of the research. It must be accurate, true, and accuracy. These are all the three important points which all the researchers must keep in mind. Once again, the characteristics, so we can keep on approach the topic of research in several dimensions, several approaches, several angles. Reliability, validity, accuracy, credibility, generalizability, empirical, systematic approach, and controlled. Of course, one can classify or one can approach the research problem in several ways and means. Depends on the type of problem they chose. Like the purpose of research, as we discussed earlier, it may be exploratory, descriptive, or explanatory. Of course, we discussed this point, fundamental and basic research or applied research. Of course, people really concentrated of late, last 20 years, more on applied research. Of course, to some extent, we must focus on fundamental and basic research also. That's what the corona COVID pandemic has highlighted. We have missed something miserably in fundamental, doing miserably the fundamental and basic research. We must initiate, once we initiate the fundamental and basic research also, along with applied research. Applied research will help the present-day living society, human society. We focus only on the applied research for the human society alone. This is highly dangerous. And also, it is making the human life miserable. So one should focus on very much fundamental and basic research also, which will give answers for the problems emanating out of problems created due to the applied research, the technological innovations, the technological research. So these are all some of the points which I don't want to explain once again, the basic points with reference to basic research and the applied research. Methods used for qualitative research. There are several approaches, the very important approaches for to do qualitative research. One-to-one interview, these are all methodology side of the research, right? One-to-one interview, focus groups. Say, for instance, in business and all, there are so many focus groups, business and management, commerce, focus groups or target groups. It may be a consumer, it may be a producer, it may be a distributor, or it may be a marketing group. So the research can be done at different groups. Even if you take biology, medical research, you can do work on children or newborn. Infections pertinent to newborns, infections pertinent to focused on teenage group, infections for middle age population, infections related to old age problem. So, of course, the point which I am really talking about the medical research is the concept behind the COVID problems. The COVID problems, people have seen much dangerous impact on the old age people who are having a lot of other comorbidities. So the focus group for any research is really important. Just like that, you cannot select a topic and include all the groups for your study. Or you can take all the groups and stratify based on the age and compare the results, which will give very fruitful and meaningful results. Ethnographic research. This will come in picture with reference to anthropology, sociology, political science, the ethnographic research. You can do a lot, archaeology. So the ethnographic research is also needed for societal development. Need not necessarily only the science and technology, right? We have to focus on various aspects of research. Content and text analysis. This is also one type of qualitative research. And case study research. But of course, in business and medical related research, the case study research is highly warranted, highly essential, highly needed. People are focused in great extent to case study research rather than the total group. Say, for instance, patients suffering to a particular disease in the age group of 1 to 10, 10 to 20, something like that. It is not like that. Case study means single patient, how he has contracted the disease, how he responded to the drug, how he is coming out of the disease, or how is the disease get cleared in his body. This case study. So the case study can be done for medical research or any social research also. Even by, say, having a single skull bone isolated from an archaeological site such as Keeledi, Manalur, what we initiated at Madurai Kamaraj University, single skull bone, you can reveal. You can demonstrate a great history of 3,000 years old history or sociology. These are all case study, specific case study based on single object, like case study in medical parlance with a single patient. You can study anything, something like that. Of course, there are other online based research tools are also available for both qualitative and quantitative research. Tools for the collection of qualitative information includes online forms, online communities, web survey, focused groups, depth interviews. Of course, many of you are aware of these aspects. Just for a comprehensive presentation, I included these slides. Tools for collecting the quantitative information includes face-to-face interview, web collection, phone data collection, mail-based collection, and central location intercept. These are all different approaches to do research. Coming to the scientific research, leave alone the other research, scientific research can be further stratified or classified or arranged based on different approaches according to data collection technique, according to causality relationship, according to relationship with the time. It may be a retrospective study or a prospective study or cross-sectional study. Now with reference to COVID also, people started in Western countries. India is still lagging behind to do research with reference to COVID, but they have already started prospective, retrospective, and cross-sectional study with reference to COVID in other parts of the globe. According to the medium through which they are applied, maybe a clinical-based research, laboratory-based research, and social descriptive research. So these are all different approaches, as I said earlier, for different disciplines. One can approach a problem with the different methodologies and approaches. Coming to business research, of course, I discussed a couple of slides earlier. You can analyze the consumer behavior, buying habits, brand preference, consumer attitudes. This is just name a few, only these 3 points. There are so many points one can attribute or one can include or one can think of to study the consumer behavior. Human resources is, of course, very highly evolved, highly concentrated area, human resource research. Employee attitudes, staff retention, material incentives. But of course, you can now do research related to the pandemic influence on human resources. Great chance for those people who are working in management discipline. Likewise, promotion, one can do research, products, and finance. Finance is another very important analytical area. One can do. People can do huge research on finance, forecasting, budgeting, efficiency of accounting or software. So many is there. Just for example, I've included a couple of these things. Finance is very, like human resource, the finance is also very important and ever-expanding area of research in management and commerce. Is there any problem listening? Audience?
No, sir.
No, sir. No, sir. Okay.
Yeah.
No, sure. Sir, you are fine.
Yeah.
Finally,
audible. For instance, yes. The youngsters, I don't know, the millennials are not aware of the angel investors. Those who are in marketing and business finance, I will know that. Others, they don't know. The larger scope for angel investors, study about angel investors, research about angel investors. Where from money comes, nobody knows. The cloud money generation. A few new areas are coming up in each field also, like science, in commerce and management and finance also, newer areas are coming up. One can really have a close watch in the magazines to find, choose the topic to do the research. So once again, we discussed a couple of occasions, the steps of a research process. You have to formulate your question. As I said earlier, the question must be a specific one related to your topic of expertise. You have to collect the basic information to do a better research, to do a good research. You must be aware, thoroughly aware about the background information about the aspect that you chose to do research. How to refine your search topic. So initially you may select a topic, maybe after 3 months of reading several topics and several research books or research summaries, the topic, you can trim the topic, right? Yeah. Consider your resource absence. How much funding is there available for you to do research? That really matters. So without money, you cannot do any research, right? That makes a lot of sufferings. So consider your resource options, either your resource option, if you are getting a fellowship directly from the central government or any other funding agency, or your investigators or your guides, financial resources, funding options available for him. So that accordingly also you can select the topic so that your research will really become a very good research and you can publish good papers. Select the appropriate tool. This is another very important one, right? So without appropriate methodologies, methods and materials, one cannot do the research. If it is for science, specific methodology, practicals. If it is for finance or management or any other social studies, right type of statistics, right methodology for data collection. It depends whether you are going to collect the data by interview or by circulation or by email or by post. So many methods are there. So you have to select the appropriate tool to data collection or data accumulation. Use the tool. You must appropriately use the tool. Locate your materials, analyze your materials, organize and write, compose your bibliography. Of course, initially, if you slightly go into these three, four topics nicely and planned manner, these things will come nicely later, no problem. So coming to another, now we have discussed about what is research, how to do research, what are all the different types of research, one can approach the research problem, how one can select the problem, we discussed a lot, to some extent, close to 25 minutes. Now we are going to another very important area, which is highly relevant to science participants. You may really enjoy hereafter. For a biologist or a science background individual or some scientist or a postgraduate student from science background, where from the research problem comes? If I ask a straight question from a participant or PG student or a student who just joined for research, he may straightforward answer my question. Sir, it is a research problem comes from my guide, many of the time. But it is not like so, right? The students can himself select a problem, novel problem. Most of the time, the research guides are much busy with their research and administrative problem, teaching problems, teaching assignments, etc., etc. So anybody can do some analysis, what to do, how to select a topic, which is highly relevant for the society, which is going to give him a better job opportunities later in their life. So everything matters. So you all can know, even without the title, I put the title here, even without title, one can easily know, you know, because this is the largest slum in Asia, a globe, one of the very biggest slum in the globe. And particularly in Asia, it is in Mumbai. It was in news in the COVID pandemic crisis. You all know what is a crisis.
You are not audible, sir.
Yeah, I'm coming. Is it okay now? Madam, is it okay now?
Yes, sir, it's fine, you are audible.
Yeah, so Tharavi, you are aware of what is the crisis now. I don't know, many people did really biological, environmental, chemical research related to this environment. A lot of potential is there. But I came across a research project results related to sociological aspects and social issues, economical aspects, related to Dharavi. You can study a lot with reference to biology, medicine, lot can be studied. It's the best example as far as COVID situation is concerned in India. You know, because this is very highly congested in 2 to 3 kilometer circumference, 7 lakh people are being living in a congested manner. That is the reason for the spread of quick spread of the COVID. It is potential. I don't know how many have started research in this area with reference to pandemics. The potential area. So one can select the topic just close to him. Just what is happening in the society based on the current situation. Yeah, you can answer why the graphy is having this color and these linings, beautiful linings. Any guess? The point is, these animals are living in jungles, forests. In order to camouflage the body, the animals having these lines and this color to escape from the enemies or predators. Otherwise, the bigger animals like lion and tiger. So it's a camouflage, a mechanism of mimicking the adaptive coloration to merge with the environment. Of course, you can see the animal now in the background of hill prominently, but in a thick forest with the great vegetation, good vegetation, it's very difficult to see this animal. That is the point. Of course, these are all the highly fantastic, fascinating topics those times. Some 50-100 years ago, people studied a lot of research with reference to animals and plants. This is some research, beautiful research, fundamental research are being conducted by many people. The worm's sperm sheds light on Darwin's mystery of mysteries. Instance of this is an instance of grass species breeding gun ovary. Fluorescent microscope reveals a sperm in red invading a female worm's body. So if you study the lower organisms, they are giving a very beautiful examples how the biological principles are happening in lower organisms, which is not happening, which is not possible to study human biology. Only from animals you can study beautiful this thing. Different species are unusually unsuccessful at interbreeding. If they do, the hybrid offspring is usually sterile. See the first sentence of this slides are going to be with you. Please read this sentence. Different species are unusually unsuccessful at interbreeding. If they do, their hybrid is usually sterile. They become sterile if they interbreed. So what a nice mechanism the nature has evolved. They have to go outbreeding. Interbreeding, they become sterile. So that's what in humans also we select skin color, status, this and that, because we want more progenies, good progenies, right? What a beautiful philosophical concept is there. This is a small animal, right? We humans, we are last in the ladder. It's a very small animal, but a beautiful mechanism they are maintaining. So principles are even with the beautiful principles are even with the tiny animals. That's what I projected this slide. There's another cutting from newspaper. Of course, all my talk hereafter for another 10-15 minutes will go with the newspaper cuttings only. It will create thinking process for the researchers. Ancient viral DNA lies dormant in humans. Anything comes to your mind? Ancient viral DNA, virus DNA, lies dormant in humans. How long? Thousands of years. Huge time period, these viral DNA, I don't know how these viruses really came to human genome. One survey showed that close to 8 to 10% of our human genome is with viral DNA. Why? What for this viral DNA has got incorporated into the human beings? Any guess? Any idea? Anybody come across? Are anybody doing research on this? To my knowledge, nobody is doing research in this area. This very nice area, and those virologists, the researchers who are doing research on viruses are working on this in Western countries. The finding is that the viruses are the close associates with human beings, time immemorial. The moment they evolved out from the monkeys or chimpanzees, gorillas, the viruses are also there with the human genome. Even with animal DNAs, the virus, virus DNA also might be there. I don't know. Anybody did research. But with the human DNA, human genome, close to 10% of DNA derived from viruses. One best example, that slide I have not included. I'll tell you in one line. There is a paper published 3-4 years ago, which states that there is a protein which is present, a gene coding for a protein which is present in virus, syncytin. You can Google and find out that paper and research. Syncytin, that is originally present in viruses, somehow got transferred to mammals, particularly humans, only because of the syncytin protein, the human embryos got implanted into the mother's uterus. What a beautiful philosophical point. Imagine there are some animals, mammals, where they deliver the baby outside. They deliver eggs and babies came out. There are some animals, the placenta is not that much developed. Only in later part of the mammalian life, the placenta has initiated. But for this placental development in mammals, the syncytin protein is highly essential, which is borrowed by the humans or mammals from the viruses. What a fantastic concept they identified. Beautiful. It came in press like anything 3-4 years ago. You Google it for syncytin protein, that really we collected or we borrowed that syncytin gene from the viruses, only by which the human embryos in the uterine wall of the mother able to bind with the uterine wall to get the nutrition nourishment from the mother. Likewise, there are several proteins which are helping the humans. That is true for many animals also. Many of the viral genes, viral proteins are helpful in animals and humans. These are all fascinating areas to do research. Unlock the marine mysteries. What we studied, what we know, what we collected information with reference to marine animals is much, 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 much less. Even the whole marine microorganism has not been listed. During COVID period, someone sent me a beautiful link by which they, from the surface, the microalgae and the red algae, the grasses are floating on the sea surface. You go below some few kilometers depth underneath the water of the ocean, few kilometers length, 3, 4, 5, 6 kilometers. Imagine there are some trenches, there are some areas. Still, there are some animals living, vertebrates, mammals, or unnamed animals are still there. The potential areas, of course, all of them, all of us will not get enough resource and provisions to go and collect those animals and do research. But what I'm telling is there are beautiful, nice areas one can study. Did you ever thought of why these underwater animals or deep sea animals are beautifully colored? Even if you see the corals underwater, these are all corals, right? These are coral, very important. And the coral bleaching is one of the indications for the climate change. Okay, leave alone this point. This is also a potential area. In Thoothukudi, there is one center, Sugandhi Devadasana. Yesterday also, some beautiful article came. During the COVID lockdown period, the coral bleaching has changed drastically. Coral growth has happened like anything. It blossomed like anything. They revealed for the last 3-4 months analysis in the Coromandel coast of South India. So coming to the colorful fishes of the underwater, all possible color combinations, combinatorial combinations of the colors, you can see organisms, not only fishes. Most of the sea animals under the water are having beautiful colors. Why? What is the reason? What is the logic behind having beautiful colors under the water? A beautiful sort of inquest. These are all areas in which one can concentrate and develop research interest in these areas. Yeah, this is a beautiful coral substratum. You can see the colored, beautiful structures and beautiful colors of the somebody diving with the scuba equipments. Coming to another interesting aspect by which Indians are proud to have these items, the curcumin, turmeric, and jasmine. What is fun about having turmeric and this jasmine? Jasmine is for smell, right? And this is for this having medical value, right? What medical value? So if you see this turmeric, these are all the compounds, chemical structures of the turmeric. Well explored, well studied, well exploited also. But the point is, first the turmeric active ingredient was not being patented in India, somewhere elsewhere. Of late, then India also claimed, and India also patented a couple of products, couple of ingredients from curcumin, from the turmeric. Curcumin 1, curcumin 2, curcumin 3. They have studied extensively also. Still you can study, still one can study. A lot of potentials are there. Likewise, jasmine, chemistry of smell. What are all there? What are all the compounds are there? Benzyl acetate, linalool, linoleyl acetate, cis jasmone, methyl anthranilate, indole. So why I'm projecting, of course, this is having medical value, anti-cancerous properties. Our women in South India has used extensively the curcumin or the turmeric, both for cooking purposes, for other oral application purpose, both having medical value. Using in food also having medical value, applying on the skin and other body parts also having a lot of medical value, particularly anti-cancerous. Jasmine also a lot of economical and social values. But I don't know how much research has gone into this area. One can do a lot of research. There are special storage grounds, or storage points close to Madurai district. You know, because Madurai is one of the important belt for jasmine cultivation. Coming to two other important plants with reference to our societal problems, prosopis and parthenia. Of course, both are not native to India. I don't know how many of the audience are able to recall where from they came from, how they invaded into India, how they imported into India. Knowingly or unknowingly, intentionally, unintentionally. Yes. This is intentionally invited problem. Actually, this plant is invited from, introduced from Russia or some other country into India purposefully to cater the livelihood of the villagers. But it is a real problem in the society now. A lot of research has gone, but I don't know what outcome came out of those research. But parthenium also people did a lot of research. This came along with, this came unintentionally, unpurposefully, along with the food grains they imported from America and other countries. As a small dust attached to the food grains, wheat and other grains, these spores or the seeds of the parthenium also get at, came along, introduced into the India. Now it is invaded almost all parts of the India. It's having a lot of environmental consequences. It supports a couple of pests. It supports pests, and pests, pest population increases, which will attack the agricultural plants. And it is an unwanted weed in the area, in the environment. It is an unwanted weed. One can do a lot of research still, though people did a lot of research. One can do research, further research also. These are all some of the very important and crucial points the people start discussing. You know, where these sparrows have gone, all gone. These are all the indicators. Why we need to have sparrows around our houses, around the environment, our green fields. Why? What is the need? These are all the important component of the environment. These are all the indicators of the good and healthy environment, without which the environment is barren. Environment is not suitable for supporting the other animals. These are all important component in the food chain of a green field environment. We have lost. In many places, these sparrows have gone. Why? Because the technology. We introduced technology for the benefit of only human beings. No animal is required these technologies, right? Of course, in limited sense to cattle estimation, cattle movement tracing, for limited extent that these technologies are useful to other animals and the plants, very limited. Even in the forest, animal tracking, they are using the satellite, this imaging or satellite tracking. But humans are using extensively, right? Everybody is having a mobile phone, everybody is having connectivities, a lot. But the danger is, they are placing these towers with the stations, these are called stations, mobile base stations, very close to the living environment. What is the problem? Having these base stations close to the residential, congested residential area, a lot of medical problems. Mobile phone towers are a major health risk. Discussed extensively in India, discussed extensively in European countries, extensively in America also. But no other go. Technology is a double-edged sword, triple-edged sword. One cannot just like that throw it away. And because we are technology dependent, technology addict, right? We did a research long back with the support of DRDO. To what extent the mobile phone frequent users are having health problems. Yes, we identified one of the important marker, HSA protein, highly elevated in the blood serum, blood plasma of those frequent mobile phone users. For this, we included the marketing managers, marketing people, and representatives who are using mobile phone very frequently. Mobile phone is a supportive evidence for your communication, right? But it is not like so today. But for everything, we depend on our mobile phones. We must put a limitation of the usage of a mobile phone to some extent, because it's having a lot of health impact also. There are groups denying that they don't have any health impact, but they do have, definitely. Coming to various other aspects, this is, of course, a cutting that I collected long back. Someone got Nobel Prize with Chinese medicine, where they demonstrated that the Chinese doctor and Nobel winner, UU2 for artemisinin. Artemisinin is a compound isolated from the herbal plants, herbs from the China. So the research topic may be come from a very small aspect, very small aspect. Did not necessarily to go into hitchhiking, a very technologically important aspect. It can come from anything, right? Very small thing. But the Chinese doctor, UU2, did more than 20, 30 years of research to finally demonstrate.
Yes. Please, sir, there is no display. There is no PPT. Please share the PPT so that people will see. PPT is not visible.
Yes.
Professor, it is visible, Professor, sir.
Visible.
Sir, please share the PPT.
Comics display.
Yes, sir.
It is visible, sir. It's visible.
Yes, sir. It is visible.
It
may be technical issues
visible.
Or the network issues. It will be coming back. The PPT will be coming back.
Yeah. It will be visible, it seems. Many people are telling. Yeah.
Yes,
this is a basic herb that is very prevalent in China, from which after her 30 years of research, he came out with a compound for malaria. This is artemisinin. It's a very important compound used in Chinese herbal medicine to combat the malaria. That is why China, barring the chloroquine and hydroxychloroquine, Chinese are using a lot of herbs which will protect them from. So we are also having a lot of such resources in Western Ghats, Himalayas, these Sundarbans. Everywhere we are having huge resources, but untapped, untouched, unexplored. This is another potential area of research. Of course, Government of India has started a separate center, dedicated center at Bangalore in the campus of IAAC, Indian Institute of Science, a stem cell center is coming up. So highly potential area, right? one of the point I want to stress here, apart from human medicine, human therapeutics, and human medical interventions, from the stem cell of the animals, from the stem cells isolated from the archaeological excavated materials, they are in the process of recreating animals. Scientists are in the process of recreating the once dominant, now lost animals. What a fantastic, fascinating area. So this is possible. There are some noises coming out. Please, the technology people can look into the matter. Yeah.
Dear participants, so, kindly mute your speakers, please. Sir, you can get...
Sir, is there any another 10 minutes more, right, for me, right? Yeah.
You have 10 minutes more, sir. You can carry over.
Yeah, yeah. Not only that, you can recreate a lost animal or extinct animal from their cells or genome. We can use it for therapy. That's what people are telling. It is a boon for the stem cell therapy. Started a lot of things are started all world over. In India, it is in the preliminary stage. As I said earlier, that Indian Institute of Science, there is a dedicated center for stem cell research. This is what I'm talking all is related to our environment, our society, problems related to the India. This is an invader animal, snail, which is supposed to came from Africa. Through sailors, ship, or several other food transportation, export, this came. This is highly dangerous, right? This animal spoil the local flora. It is highly invasive. The snails are highly invasive since there are few predators. Very few predators, because these are all African based. Somehow they entered into the India. Because of the few number of predators, they flourish. And they affect the local fauna. So these are all the crucial issues. Some Kerala group is working on this, identifying this animal, characterizing this animal, and controlling this snail, which is accidentally introduced from the East Africa. A couple of slides I skip because this is very, very recent. Many of you aware of the press notifications very recent time. These animals, these insects actually migrated far away from the Iran and the Middle Eastern part of countries through Pakistan and into India. They never came that recent past here in India. Because some of the literatures quoted that some 100 years ago or 80, 100 years ago, some such invasive migrations have happened in India also due to the climatic change and environmental degradation or environmental changes. These are moving into many researchers now started how these insects are moving in bulk into India and what consequence they make in the agriculture field. One important point I want to stress with reference to this locust attack. A recent attack is that some 3 months ago I came across a newspaper article, some journal, some English this thing. 10,000 deaths, like.
Sir, sorry to interrupt you a little. I am a MPhil research scholar from gender study. It is just a request, sir, if you keep your examples and indicators little interdisciplinary. Because there are participants, actually it is a little, totally biological science oriented. So if you can keep our streams also in little mind, and if you can have the approach little interdisciplinary, sir, it is just a request.
Yeah, that is what in the first part of my lecture, I introduced everything in a generalized manner. But since I'm a faculty from a biology, I'm giving extra examples from biology. But anyway, the initial points, initial 10-20 slides, what I discuss are, it's common for everyone, general approach, what is research, how to do research are all very common to that. But anyway, we have come to the end of the story, right? Only a few slides are left. So this problem, this is not only a biological problem. The biologist can study about the biology of this locust. Economists can study about the economic consequences of this locust attack. Sociologists can study about the sociological imbalances or sociological problems created among the societies, agricultural societies, due to the locust cost. You can correlate anything with any environmental event, right? So you have to think, you have to keep thinking, and we may get some points. Of course, we have discussed earlier, so I'm just skipping. This is with reference to stem cell. I'm not giving much. This slide also, this is like making babies, artificial insemination or artificial DNA, this thing. They can, very sometime ago, this case came, like a granddaughter of the Netaji Subhas Chandra Bose really wanted to find out whether what's the fate of the grandfather, Netaji Subhas Chandra Bose. His daughter calls for DNA testing, you know, because they maintained his burials, bones and other things somewhere in some place. So they wanted to test. So of course this happened. This is for some political and historical connections. We can do any biologist or any anthropologist, any sociologist can initiate related research, which is lacking in India, which is not that much bothered, which was not given attention. Such research can be initiated in India. Not only biology, you can do, anthropologists can do, sociologists can do, archaeologists can do, geologists can do such research. This is with reference to botany. People can find out what type of plant is being exported, or cut from which forest, what type of plant it is. From the genome, they can find out from which forest the logs are being cut out and exported clandestinely. So everything can be studied. Of course, a couple of medical related, I'm skipping because of the time constraint. The obese kids prone to high BP. So one of the COVID important social problem is it will affect the individuals who are having high BP, heart problem, nervous problem, and gastrointestinal problems, where the angiotensin converting enzyme gene, ACE receptor is expressed more. So in BP patients, ACE receptor expression is more. So that is why the virus infects the people who are having high BP, heart problem, and other neurological problems. So this is a matter of very important aspect. Even biology, non-biology, and sociological people can take a lead. The ICSSR recently called for research proposals some 2 weeks ago. Now, last it is over. Sociology relevant to COVID. So any social scientist can send a proposal, even management, social anthropologist, economist, anybody can send a proposal with reference to COVID. You can study how much obese individuals with BP are prone for infection with reference to COVID. It's a heart related, not science, arts related, sociological related problem. So these are all some of the slides that I collected long back, but you can correlate with the recent problem. Even sociologists can correlate with the recent problem. So a couple of slides I want to skip. This we discussed earlier, the ancient viruses once foes may now serve as a friends, researchers. That's what I told you now, that science-18 virus protein that we acquired from some virus will help for the newly developed fetus to attach to the mother's womb in the uterus, somehow be retained into the human genome. The viruses are useful. Due to the time constraint, due to the situation, the viruses mutate and becomes lethal, lead to a lot of diseases. Again, a couple of slides I want to skip. Another, this I want to tell is, of course, not only science, anybody can do this research. How much vegetables people are consuming, how much energy anybody can get. In the same way, the more they use vegetables, the more they're prone for getting pesticide accumulation in their body. What will happen if pesticide accumulates in the body? If pesticide accumulates in the body, it will affect several organs, more particularly the islets of Langerhans, leading to diabetic mellitus. So we don't know. No research have come. Very recently in India, people did some research. Madurai Kamaraj University also, our group did some research and identified the pesticide residues in human blood lead to diabetes. This is, of course, the chemist can work, biologist can work, environmental scientist can work, and also some social scientists can also work with reference to the bad effects of pesticides on human life. This is a paper we published in genome research, which will explain the bad consequence of accumulation of pesticides among the agricultural field workers. Coming to the last part of few slides of my talk, we have initiated a collaborative research with in collaboration with the Tamil Nadu Government Archaeology Department in Kiladi, Kundagai, Manalur, and the Ragaram and other places of South Tamil Nadu, wherein we are collecting samples, different samples, the bone material, pot shreds, lot of material, artifacts we are collected. But of course, this is not from our sites, just for example, I have collected it from other points, other sources. So from this, by using this, not only biologists, anthropologists can do the, some work, archaeologists can work, historian can work, sociologist can work, theologist can work. Of course, our team consists of several such people who started working on several aspects. And of course, we have started just, we don't know how we are going to completely finish the work. It is just a humble beginning. It's the first type of work within India. Earlier, they did something in North India, Rakhigari and other places in Punjab, but with collaboration with the Harvard University. We are also looking in some foreign universities, but it's yet to start. It's a potential area. Just I'm highlighting for the social science students also, a lot can be done with reference to archaeological excavations in India. The couple of slides with reference to chemistry, I don't want to go into much detail. I'm just skipping. The point is, the chemistry is ever-blooming and ever-growing field because many diseases are coming, for which scientists are sorry, there are some interruptions. So the more the diseases, you want more drugs. Actually, this scientist, Robert Burns Woodward, got Nobel Prize in the year 1965 for outstanding achievements in the art of organic synthesis. So those who are in science field, particularly in chemistry, synthetic chemistry, it is a very boom for them, because India, the resources for extraction from plants, marine resources, is very huge. So the simple change, small change in the molecules, say for instance, small change at the CH3 attachment site really matters. They change the complete properties of the chemical, and hence the drug property may change. Skipping a couple of slides. And if you see, these are all some slides showing HIV/AIDS drugs, right? And a lot of drugs are there. But you know, there are so much drugs being synthesized, but all these drugs are having side effects. If you, the human community started taking synthetic drugs for HIV and AIDS, they develop other side effects, other diseases as well. You have to keep in mind, it's like a double-edged sword, these drugs. But potential is there. A lot of potential is there in synthetic chemistry to identify new compounds. That is what new initiative is there, initiated for COVID also, to identify new drugs and vaccines. This remdesivir is a vaccine drug being used for, earlier used for Ebola viral infection in Africa, now being tried extensively for coronavirus infection. Earlier, it is being used for SARS and MERS also. For coronavirus infections, including MERS, SARS, and COVID, it is having some potential of support, and people started working on further development of remdesivir, further new compound synthesis from remdesivir. Lot of work is going on, so we may able to get good drugs in future. So I don't want to discuss this. Is chirality is a small change in a small chemical molecule will change the complete properties of the chemical molecule. So that is called chirality. So for instance, the spearmint leaves, they extracted carvon. This is a structure. Likewise, caraway seeds, they extracted another carvon. See, if you see the close structure, the bond, the C bond attached to the main ring, benzene ring, is towards us, right? It is very close to our, facing us. Whereas in this caraway seed extracted carvon, it is facing away from us, right? So structurally, otherwise all the chemical compositions are same. The bond attachment is close to us, close to facing the person who is seeing the chemical molecule. This is away from us. So only because of the structural arrangement, property varies. Total, complete variation, right? So a lot of potential is there, drug, this thing. So it is up to the student and the investigator to apply their mind and do research. Say for instance, the same example, this is away from the person who is seeing the compound. This is direct to the person who is seeing the compound. What is happening? This is from smell of oranges, right? This is orange, this is smell of lemon, right? It is because all other way the compound is same, but the arrangement, how it is being attached with the main ring, it really matters. It gives a different smell for orange as well as lemon. Everything matters. Arrangement also matters, not only the composition. So I'm just skipping a couple of slides. And last slide, the very recent one, I take it from day before yesterday's this thing. This is what happened very recently in US. Very, very cracking problem. It is making nuisance in the countryside. It's keep on the cicadas. The cylinder is nothing but a cicadas making a huge noise around the environment. It's a social problem, not the biological problem. Of course, there are some biological problems. It affects some other insects, other plants. But for humans, it's highly irritating, the sound. Very recent one. Yeah, but I don't know whether any research is going on, sociological or science research going on with reference to the cicadas in India. So with this,
பாலகிருஷ்ணன் சார், சார் வாய்ஸ் பிரேக் ஆயிடுச்சு, அன்மியூட் பண்ணி பேசுங்க சார்.
பாலா சார், ப்ளீஸ் அன்மியூட் யுவர் மைக்ரோஃபோன்.
Sir, it is muted. Unmuted.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your nice presentation. I request participants to ask any queries. If you have any doubts, please clarify with sir.
Ma'am, may I request for this PPT if you share in the group or email, so we are more benefited?
Sure, we'll share it, sir.
The recordings will be shared, sir.
Thank you.
Hello, sir. Sir, I have one query.
Yes, ma'am.
Please do.
Actually, sir, I wanted to just ask, what is the difference? Is there a difference between approaches and the types of research?
What is the difference between the approaches and the type of research?
Type of research, yes, sir. Because I'm a little bit confused right now, that's why.
Yes. Approaches is different and type of research is different. Say, for instance, it may be a qualitative research or quantitative research. That is a type of research. Approach is whether you are going to field and do some work, whether you are going to sit in the lab and do some work. So this is approach, right?
Okay.
So the approach is different and the type of research is different. You have to be very clear about between these two aspects.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
So the qualitative research, qualitative and the quantitative will be in approaches, or will it be a type of research, sir? Because like so far, whatever I've learned from my previous workshops, everyone said qualitative types of research is qualitative research, quantitative research. So like I'm a little confused, that's why, sir.
No, it's a type of research, qualitative. You can classify that research based on several aspects. Qualitative, quantitative type of research classification is one type. So type of research.
Sir. Yeah. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Do anybody have any other clarification or questions that do we raise?
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, sir. I have a question. Sir, in the research process, you mentioned about case study. So if you can, sir, throw a little elaborative light on how to do case study. What is case study?
Madam, the case study depends which field you are in case study. What is research?
In social science, I am from a social science field, but in general, I wanted to know a little broad idea about what case study research is.
Yes, for instance, the first slide I projected is Tharavi. If you study anything about Tharavi, it is a case study.
Sir, one more thing. In scientific research or medical research, along with the experimental work, can we include this case study for maybe in one or two aspect? I'm doing the PhD in the medical science, and most of work basically relevant to the collection of data, maybe experiment. And all these things. So, can we include some case study option in our research work?
Yes, you can combine both the case study as well as the data collection. That is the
okay, sir.
Yeah, you can include both. You can include both. It depends. Yeah, if you involve people from social science, you can include both case studies as well as the social studies. There is no harm.
Okay. No. Thank you. Thanks.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. My question is, if I want to take do a research on case study, which reliable data I need to take?
I'm not able to hear the question clearly.
I request other participants to mute yourself.
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, you can ask your question.
Hello.
Yes, madam.
I have one query, sir, because funding resources that you have mentioned, sir, because we are from different field areas and so many programs have been running, but is there any site or links, sir, where we can go and get the information regarding the funding schemes and all?
You are asking a question related to funding options.
Sir, funding, yes, sir.
Yeah, funding. Lot of funding possibilities are available with reference to Indian context. Maybe the government, the last 3-4 years, the funding provisions are a little reduced. Now for COVID, they called for DST, ICMR, DBT, ICSSR. So much grants have been announced and called for. Many people have got already. Still there is a scope. Still there are some projects you can apply.
Because most of the schemes has been on hold, sir, because of the COVID, sir. Because last year, if I remember, may most of the schemes have been announced, but now this time, sir, they are on hold. So, is there any scheme still going on, sir, so that we can apply? Because most of the schemes like DST, DBT, ICMR.
Yeah, without COVID, beyond COVID also you can apply. Any fundamental research can also be applied. No problem. You can apply. I don't know how many participants from Tamil Nadu. Now the government of Tamil Nadu Planning Commission has called for research proposals. Planning Commission, government of Tamil Nadu. Last date to apply is 15th June. Still open, right? You can go to the government website and apply for government of Tamil Nadu project, those who are in Tamil Nadu state.
Thank you so much for the information, sir.
Thank you.
That is only for Tamil Nadu, sir. Hello.
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 Yes.
Hello. Yes. Sir, I am Dr. Ganesh Kumari, sir. Sir, I want to know that whether the private college faculty can able to apply for a government project proposals.
Yes. Hundreds of proposals are being awarded to private colleges and universities.
Sir, since we are temporary faculty, is there eligibility for us to apply?
No, you are eligible, but the thing is, they want some permanent faculty to be included along with you, if possible. Okay. In your college, if regular courses are available, you can include some regular faculty also as one of the co-investigator, then it is possible.
No, sir, we are not having any aided courses, so we can combine with other college staffs, no, sir? It is possible.
Yes.
No?
Yeah, okay. That is possible. That is also possible, even without a permanent faculty member also possible. You can apply, you can get, it depends on the viability of the project and proposal strength, you will get it.
Oh, but so we can get, even if don't have any government faculty.
Yes.
Usually I can also apply as a private faculty.
Many people applied, many people got and submitted the proposals. Yeah.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Sir, any grant by the government for the students, those are doing the research in the private sector, suppose they are not qualified any NET GRF examination. I am Rajneesh Prajapat from Udaipur, Rajasthan.
Yes, there are possibilities. You can apply without the CSIR NET and UGC NET, you can apply for other funding sources.
Example of this category, sir?
There is one funding agency called Bureau of Police Research and Development, BBRD. Those who are in social sciences doing research in defense, police research, forensic biology, sociology can apply for BBRD, Bureau of Police Research and Development. This is one example. Yeah, ICSSR you can apply. ICSSR, now it is a call for. For postdocs, their separate call for is still available. For postdocs in social sciences, ICSSR.
Okay, sir. Thank you for this.
Yeah.
Hello, sir.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes.
Sir, I am Prashad from Tamil Nadu. Can I ask one question, one more?
Yes. Welcome.
What about ethnographic research, sir?
Ethnographic?
Research.
Ethnographic research is something to do with the anthropology, sociology, and to some extent the history, right? The fields of social sciences. So as far as our country is concerned, as far as the Tamil Nadu is concerned, the ethnography research is very minimal, you know, because very few universities are offering anthropology, sociology departments. So ethnography research is very minimal, but a lot of scope is there in future.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
I request the participants to mute your phones, microphones. If you have any queries, kindly post in the webinar login or else into our WhatsApp group.
Ma'am, what about the assignment of today's report?
Sir, you are not clearly audible, sir.
Ma'am, I'm talking about assignment, today's assignment.
Right, sir, we will be letting you about the assignment.
Okay.
Let us complete the session first. And okay. After the completion of the session, we will let you know. Yeah. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for brief report on water research. I would like to call Dr. B. Maithili Nyanamangai, Assistant Professor, Department of Biotechnology, K.S. Rangaswamy College of Technology, to propose the vote of thanks. Yes, ma'am, I'm on the line. Okay. So at last we have come to an final part of this event. So the best and the beautiful thing in the world cannot be seen or even touched. They must be felt by heart. Thank you is one such feeling among them. We all are here in a time, the world that has never seen before. We are in a pretty long quarantine because of COVID-19. And I think learning and knowledge has never been more imperative than it is now. Continuous learning and acquiring knowledge and skills to face world problems has become a necessity, especially in this realm of environment. I consider it a great privilege to propose a vote of thanks to all the dignitaries who have witnessed this as a memorable and successful event. Today, my words are not enough to express the gratitude. On behalf of our college, I would like to thank Dr. P.V. Srinivasan, Director, Nature Science Foundation, Coimbatore, who graced us with his welcome address that set a perfect initial platform for the inauguration of 21 days virtual course on research methodology. I would like to thank our beloved principal, Professor Dr. R. Gopalkrishnan, sir, K.S. Rangaswamy College of Technology, for all words of wisdom that radiated a source of energy within us. We will ever remain grateful to you.
Maithili,
voice is muted.
You are not audible. Maithili, unmute yourself,
Maithili. Okay, sir.
Dr. Maithili, right, okay.
I would like to thank our beloved principal, Professor Dr. R. Gopalkrishnan, sir, K.S. Rangaswamy College of Technology, for all words of wisdom that radiated a source of energy within us. We will remain grateful to you, sir, and thank you for being with us today on virtual mode. I reserve my special thanks to Mrs. Rajalakshmi, Chairman, Nature Science Foundation, Coimbatore, for extending her support for initiating this virtual course today. Heartfelt thanks to goes to our HOD, Professor Dr. J. Philip Robinson, for his felicitation today, and all other faculties of Department of Biotechnology who always stand by us, guide us, lead us, and motivate us. We feel proud and thank you for making us feel happy with your presence to this function. Special thanks to our chief guest of the day, Dr. K. Balakrishnan, sir, Professor and Head Department of Immunology, Madurai Kamaraj University, Madurai, who delivered a wonderful talk on what is research
and he made us to know different value of research and for all his efforts to bring a mind map on research. Thank you, Professor, for your patience and kindness in addressing the various questions of the interested participants. An event of this dimension cannot happen overnight, but the wheel started rolling very fast in a short span of time. We have been fortunate enough to be backed up by a team of very motivated and dedicated student communities and then research scholars and volunteers. I personally thank everyone enough for their involvement they have shown and the willingness they have expressed to take on the completion of the task beyond their comfort zones. Last but not least, I thank all the participants from various institutes of the part of all parts of the country for showing their interest in this program. Thank you, participants. Once again, I thank you very much to all who logged in here and stood up with great patience. Thank you, participants. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Dr. Maitli Nanamangai.
Hello, ma'am. Hello. Please send today's assignment, ma'am.
Yes, hello.
Today's assignment.
Yeah, regarding today's assignment, I think professor and head of Department of Biotechnology has posted what's to be done for today's assignment. Hope some of them have doubts over it, right? Okay. I would like to clear the doubt. Okay. So we require the title of the assignment.
Okay,
sir. We require just the title of the assignment or the book chapter, what you are going to write, what you are going to submit to our organization so that can be published or that can be published as a book chapter. So we need assignment title that has to be sent it to the given mail ID editorum2020@gmail.com. It is just sir, the title sir, alone.
Sir, yes, it's my humble, sir, one thing, like we propose one title on which we're going to write the article.
Yes.
Is it clear, sir?
Yes, you are free to choose your title.
Okay, sir.
You are each and everyone
sir.
Because each and
sir,
everyone.
Please update, sir. Yes, sir. Sir, please update this email ID in the group so we can share our topic of interest. I'm Rajnish from
Rajasthan.
Excuse me, Dr. Zamir. Yes, hello. Sir. Yeah, in addition to that, tomorrow we will send you a model. We will send you a model paper. It is a minimum of 8 to 10 pages report. We will send as a model. I request the participant, please go through it. And you are from various discipline. You can interpret and you can plan and you can identify a title based on your area of interest or your area of work. And you can start to prepare slowly. And we will tell the deadline also within a week, around a week we will give. After that, you can submit. Then we will consider and we will give the corrections and we will do the processing work for the same. Okay. You will get an idea about the research methodology and the topic. Some of you are already completed your doctoral research, or some of you are maybe pursuing, but your area of interest, based on your area of interest, you can plan. We will share you a model report for you through mail. You can go through it and you can feel free to contact after receiving the model. Okay.
Sir, one more request, please share your material.
Sir, I have a question.
We can write. Sir, please share some area.
Kindly. Ask questions one by one. If each and everyone, yes, we are unable to hear and we are unable to answer the questions.
Sir, only right. One request. Please share some area in which like medical.
Okay, I want
so
to know.
You want us to share the areas in which you want to write your title.
Okay, sir.
We are giving you a free hand.
Okay,
sir. You may be an expert in one field.
Okay,
we are giving you a free hand. You choose your title because you are all from various domains.
Yes.
You are not in a specific domain. You all are from a different domains. We are giving you free hand to choose your particular domain in which you are expert. When you show this as a book chapter published in your biodata, that will speak about you.
Okay, sir.
You are asked.
Plagiarism. Yes. So that will be easy for us to speak with the publishers.
Yes.
Sir, I have a question. Sir, regarding tomorrow's assignment, now we will be sharing the title. But after we go through this entire course, do you have the free hand to update our title and send it to you again?
Yeah, before the deadline, we will give the deadline. Before the deadline, you can made the minor alteration because we will give some deadline. During that time, you can do some kind of alteration in the title.
Sir, for tomorrow, we just need to submit only the title. Means, what is our today's homework actually?
You can submit only the title.
Your area. You can identify your area. You can register your title. So that we will send you some, we will send you a common model for the work. You can go through that. We can give the identify the title. You can go through the previous research paper, how they have written and what are all the current updation. Everything you can read up. That is the main work today. And based on that, tomorrow onwards, you can plan. You can start to write by your own. That is the thing.
So the title we have to send tomorrow, not today.
Yeah, tomorrow. You can send it tomorrow.
Is there any other question? It should be in the form of paper or something like that, sir.
In a form of email?
No, I mean the assignment.
Everyone, yeah.
Yeah, the assignment you said it should be in the form of a research paper or?
Yes, yes, of course. Good. If it is, it may be a report or it may be a research paper format. Or it may be a review of literature format, it may be a short communication format, anything. But ensure that it must not exceed 10 page.
Okay, okay. Thank you, sir.
Hello. Hello, sir.
We request if you can send the model by
sir,
model.
Yeah, we will send you.
We will send you through mail.
Hello.
Yes.
Ha, sir, module related to maths also.
Yes, yes, yes. Sir, you can do, you can use the software tools, whatever it may, it is applicable in mathematics, you can give. So then we can categorize. For example, there are 100 participants are there. We will categorize it a different domain before go for the process. During the time, we will categorize. After receiving, we will categorize. Even it is applicable for mathematics because without mathematics, any biological research can we can't publish. Statistics is very important. You can interpret. Even in mathematics, you can identify area, you can interpret.
Okay.
Sir,
hello.
Sir, please send the format also.
Yes, sir. We are assured that we will send you. We will send you, sir.
Sir, excuse me. Sir, yes. Sir, shall we include figures and tables like photographs, tables?
Yes, you can include.
Okay, okay, sir. Okay, thank you.
Sir, tomorrow can we share a broad title and according to your recommendation, your correction, we can define the title later on?
No, you can teach again and again. We are telling that from various disciplines, various disciplines. Broad title, you can share. We will give you deadlines. Before the deadline, you can share, you can change, you can do the modification of the title. Because yes, within a day, we can't complete the title.
Okay.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Hello, sir.
Yes, please.
When this recorded video will be available anywhere in any platform so that we can go and check later?
Yeah, we will send you the thing.
Okay. And can you send the instruction for today's assignment through mail to everyone so that we just look into it because it's quite confusing?
We will send you.
I've already instructed.
Thank you.
It's of your own choice. The title will be of your own choice.
Thank
Hello,
you.
Sir. Right, okay. Hello, yes. Sir.
Yes.
Hello, sir. Please send the email ID.
Sir, we have one humble request. Hello, sir. Can you hear?
Yeah, ask one by one. It is better to hear.
Sir, yes, we have one request, sir, because through this software, we have a lot of problems, sir. Can you just upload these movies to any software in YouTube or any other softwares? Because here's a lot of problems. We sometimes
can't hear their lecture. So if we go through this software, whenever we have any doubt about the questions, about the topic, we ask the lecturers.
Dr. Samir. Yeah, I have observed that some of them have real difficulty. So I think to most of them, I have made personally a call to them and I have instructed what are the things that has to be done. So we are making so that you will be easily adapting to this software. As I've already mentioned, there are other pirated software. We are not using those pirated software. This is the registered pattern what we have got from Microsoft Teams. Here we can allow more than 1,000 people at a single platform. This is a platform where we can join with even with more than 1,000 people.
User friendly software only. I hope most of you understand how to use the software as well as laptop. I think it is better.
There may be some quite difficulty. But I think so. Now I can find around 167% have joined today. Around 167% have joined today. So that we are adapting to this particular software. This software is easy for everyone. That's what I want to say.
But sir, we are not able to learn, sir. We are not able to learn because there is a lot of interruption. What's the advantage of this software?
Okay. I want to insist that this interruption is artificial.
So right now I can't hear your voice, sir. What you are talking about, I can't understand you.
Network failure. The voice interruption may be due to a network failure, or else some of the participants are not muting themselves. Some of the participants.
No, sir. Yeah, that's true. But this course is not for 2 days, for 3 days, but it is for 21 days.
Sir, do we have any second session today, or the session is over with this session, sir, for today?
Yeah, this session will be over for today's session. This is for all out session now.
Tomorrow. Hello.
Another session, right? Yes.
Hello. Good morning.
Yes, good morning.
Doctor, I'm Dr. Anil Kumar. You see, I had a technical problem right from morning 9:30. You see, now right, I was able to resolve it. I missed a very valuable session. You see.
Anil Kumar, I was instructing over your phone with you, right?
Yeah, right. And
we are technically making each and everyone, we are calling each and everyone, starting a problem.
Fine.
Make sure that all the participants are equipped with the software.
Yeah. Now, what I need to know,
and I request all participants
please.
To mute yourself. We have an option of muting here. I can mute everyone.
Okay, fine.
While speaking, you have
to mute it.
Even the speaker should
unmute
be muted.
It.
And I have to request the speaker to unmute them.
Fine.
So I don't want to do that.
Okay.
So I request all the participants to mute themselves. Once they are rejoining again, and I allow them to rejoin. They are leaving.
Sir, I have one.
Hello.
Just a second. Certain participants are leaving the platform and again they are rejoining. While rejoining, what I am accepting the rejoining to enter into the platform. But during that time, they are not muting their microphone. I request them once to leave and enter into the platform. I request all the participants to mute themselves, so that the speaker may not get disturbed or other participants may not be disturbed.
Okay. Hello. By tomorrow, all these problems should be resolved.
Sir, I have one doubt and one suggestion, sir.
Yes, right.
Can I speak?
Yeah, you can speak.
Yeah. Sir, that suggestion is that can we have the recorded version of everyday's session so that due to some network problem or current cut, we happen to come out of the session.
If you post it in the group, it will be useful for everyone so that we may rewind if at all we happen to encounter any doubt.
Yes, sure. You will get it, ma'am.
Okay. And one more thing, sir. I am a language student. Okay. So I just want to know the funding areas and the topics in which I can further forward the research.
Hello. Hello, sir. One question. Sir, how to send a photo?
Sir, I have already mentioned it in the WhatsApp group. It is directornsf@gmail.com.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
It is directornsf@gmail.com. If you have any further queries, you can WhatsApp. Our team members, our faculty members are there to help you out from it. Or you can email to directornsf@gmail.com. So you will getting a reply or you will be getting a voice call from our end.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Right, okay. Any other thing?
Hello, professor. Sorry, I would be once again bothering you. Kindly excuse me. I missed this morning session. Now, my suggestion is that as other madam was telling, now all these contents and the PPTs of the experts, would you please just make a link and that can be uploaded to that link and it will be useful for us to download it and then we can just go through it.
Yes, we will be sending
yes.
you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Right. Thank you, sir. Thank you for this.
Right, yes, sir.
Yes, thank sir. You for all your cooperation. The second day session will start by tomorrow 10 a.m. sharp. We are very thankful to the strength. There are almost all people you are aligned to the topic. We are thankful to you. And if there is no any queries, then we can wind up the session. We will go for the next tomorrow's preparation.
Yes, Mr. Shankar, you can ask the question. Your voice is not audible. Hello. 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 Okay, let us end up this session. Tomorrow's link will be forwarded to you by today evening. So I request all the participants to join at the earliest. Link will be opened by 9 a.m. itself. If you feel any difficulty, you are free to call our team members. Our team members will help you. Thank you for attending this session. On behalf of the organization, organizers, thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.